tell you what, Flair, I think, is going to call it right down the middle. Flair's had his issues with both men. The Undertaker's issues with Flair are well documented, as we mentioned. Austin fined $5,000 last week by Flair for giving Flair a stunner after Flair warned him for Austin to keep his hands off of Flair.
Boy, this place is electric, JR. Look at every person in Kemper Arena's on their feet.
Rick Flair called him for the bell.
How are you, Flair? I just get over in the corner and stand there very quietly.
Well, Flair's never done anything quietly. And he's never been anybody to stand around, the former 16-time world champion. Now the owner of Raw, and these two men, The Undertaker and Stone Cold Steve Austin, deeply proud.
Uh-oh, look out.
Knowing what's on the line here. Look at that size advantage The Undertaker has. Close to 7 feet tall.
This is for the number one contender, and both of these men feel in their heart that they're number one.
Today, one of these guys are going to be number one.
Here we go.
Hard elbow tie up. The Undertaker with the advantage here for the side headlock. The Undertaker, as we said, close to 7 feet tall, 300 pounds, taking on Stone Cold Steve Austin and that Texas Rattlesnake.
Oh, he's cheating already.
He lives to be the WWF champion, but certainly the same can be said for The Undertaker. Undertaker, as we said, size and power, he has the advantage. Austin feeling it there. Knocked down hard in that shoulder block.
Match like this, they are to take you right out of your game plan. I can assure you that Stone Cold Steve Austin wasn't expected to be knocked down, and he's dazed. Let's face it, he's dazed right now. He wasn't expecting that this early in the match.
I think it was midweek before Austin was undazed in that chair shot that he sustained at the hands of The Undertaker as we went off the air last week on Raw. The Undertaker certainly got the last shot in and on that occasion. And
Undertaker said he'll out-wrestle him or he'll out-fight him.
Undertaker's like a giant black cat. He's got a lot of lives and he's got great agility.
Bad luck for you, you know, if you cross the path.
A lot of super heavyweights are Clydesdales. They plod along and The Undertaker's got, he's just an amazing athlete. His quickness is
look
very.
At look at the strength.
Very misleading. Austin trying to get that side headlock. Undertaker bites out of it. Austin delivers a shoulder tackle. But The Undertaker too big, too strong.
That's intimidating, JR. You know it is.
He got set, and yes, it is. Austin knocked down by the tackle. Could not put The Undertaker down with his tackle. They're being somewhat.
You know, it's amazing. I mean, Austin is a big, big guy. But The Undertaker, like you said, he towers over Austin.
Austin's at over 250 pounds.
And oh, wait a minute. Checking the time. He thinks he's wearing a watch.
You know what?
Wait a minute, he's working out. What the heck? That's just a little intimidation on the part of the Rattlesnake.
Mind games. That's some Victoria, Texas mind games by Dr. Austin. He is the master of the mind games, the psychology. Getting in somebody's head. He's seen it on many occasions. And again, another hard shot by The Undertaker, taking Austin down. He's looking to him. And Austin counters on what he does best, and that's deliver a thunderous right hand that caught The Undertaker coming in. And now look at Austin. Well, is The Undertaker truly number one? He'll be number one if he beats Austin. Undertaker side headlock.
You know, I don't understand why Austin doesn't just wrestle and leave off the mind games. Why'd he have to do that?
He can wrestle. Arm track takedown. Austin taking Austin. Taking down off his feet. Dropping toe hold. Austin right up into that upper arm now. Austin now pulling back on that elbow. I tried to hyperextend the elbow of The Undertaker.
Austin can wrestle, can he?
Oh, of course he can. As good as anybody in the WWF, period. And now, that's a good psychological move, good tactical move. That big tricep muscle of The Undertaker. Look at the position of that left knee of Austin. It's buried right into the tricep of The Undertaker.
Yeah, and a big metal brace to boot there.
And you want to Charlie horse that thing up. And it certainly lessens the effectiveness, obviously, of The Undertaker's left arm.
Uh-oh, look out here.
Austin now shooting that half Nelson. Undertaker pinning predicament. And Flair there to get a two count out of him. very deliberate count. I think you'll see that all night long. I know that the competitors are too concerned about the count as long as it's the same every time.
Don't you know Flair's going to hate to count out either one of these guys? I mean, what do you think the Undertaker would do to Flair if Flair were to count him out? Or vice versa, no, Stone Cold, either one of these guys.
Both men very cautious here in the early going. Neither can afford to make a mistake. There's no redos here. There's no net. There's not two out of three falls. It's one fall to a finish, and the winner of the one fall will be the number one contender and will be the undisputed champion at Judgment Day.
I don't even know why Flair would want to be in the same ring with these two guys. They both hate him. Oh, man. Oh,
yeah. Hard knockout chops by Austin. That's right out of Ric Flair's playbook. Irish Whip, far side. Great presence of mind, flexibility, and then power. The Undertaker's got it all. Looking for the cover here. And he's got a near fall there. Flair with a two count. Flair is not an experienced referee. He is, and I've oftentimes criticized special guest referees because they just don't have the game experience.
And Flair is not an experienced owner either. If he was as smart as Mr. McMahon, can you imagine Mr. McMahon ever being putting himself in a position like this?
He has.
Huh?
He's even wrestled.
Well, that's smart because, I mean, let's face it, he's a tough competitor.
Well, he is a tough competitor, but he's not a 16-time former world champion. And now the Undertaker.
Here's some old school Undertaker.
Vintage old school Undertaker.
Boom! Right across the back of the rattlesnake's neck.
And there's a cover by the Undertaker from the top rope. And Austin scoots out of there.
The snakes up next.
That Austin certainly does, and right now it's hurt. The rattlesnake does.
Do you see what I'm seeing there, JR? I think Flair is definitely intimidated by the Undertaker.
Oh, Luthes press. Stone Cold with a Luthes press.
He's opening up again, a whip ass. Here it comes.
Oh, and driving that elbow right into the sternum of the Undertaker, hooking the leg. Flair's got a. They've got a two count.
That count by Flair.
That's deliberate. That's what I pointed out earlier. If you've been listening to me,
deliberately slow.
I don't know if it's deliberately slow, but it's the same count every time.
Watch it.
And Undertaker, Stone Cold on the outside. Both these guys are brawlers, but both can wrestle. Can wrestle as well as anybody in the WWF. Shot and Austin fighting back. Undertaker and Austin laying the leather at each other here on the outside. They're encouraging both men to get back to the ring. One fall to a finish here, so Flair would be somewhat reluctant to utilize his counter. Undertaker bouncing off the security wall.
Come on, Flair, get out there. Come on,
South. And the Texas Rattlesnake not going to miss this opportunity. Follow the Undertaker out and inflict more pain.
Watch it, Dale. No Spanish.
Undertaker's head ran right into the Spanish announce table.
Keep him up there.
Undertaker's got a faraway look in his eye. And a hard knock hit by Austin. And Austin, he's really asserting himself here, King. And Flair's letting this thing go.
I don't think Flair has any choice. I don't think it could be stopped by the referee. It might only be able to be stopped by the Red Cross.
Austin adjusting those knee braces as he gets back up on the apron. And the Undertaker goes with that huge foot right to the face of Stone Cold. Man, Undertaker showing, again, great presence of mind and flexibility. And a weakened in kind of an awkward state to catch Austin right in the face of that big boot. Now Austin's head and his upper body bouncing off the announce table.
Get out of here.
Austin again knocked down. Knocked on the table and bounces up, but he's on Dream Street here. Austin barely able to stand as the Undertaker now is punishing Stone Cold Steve Austin.
You're scared, JR. Just get behind me.
Oh! All right. Austin blocking it. Trying to keep his head off that climb for that steel steps.
Oh, here comes that rattlesnake.
Austin fighting back. Right hand. That's what brought him to the dance. Undertaker.
Something. Don't let him fight out in the fans.
Flair there trying to get these men back in the ring. It's easier said than done. With the stakes as high as this match. It's a choking the Undertaker. There now. You're not going to be able to reason with these men, but I can understand where it's coming from.
No, you can't. I'll tell you where he's coming from. He's afraid. He's afraid to assert himself. He's intimidated. Watch it.
They're going to throw him back over the timekeeper's table. Right into the steps or the ring post. And again, Austin, now topping away at the Undertaker. These men have been outside a long, long time.
But what's he going for here?
Austin is going to try to pile drive the Undertaker. He's going to try to use a pile driver. And Austin backdrops out of the pile driver. And the Undertaker drops that elbow on Stone Cold. This is not a hardcore match, even though it's turning into one.
That's your record for you. He's letting you back in the ring.
It's a brawl. Why are you so careful? Where's the ice shake? What's he ever done to you?
Well, he should just call it right down the line. First of all, he shouldn't even be in there.
He pays you a lot of money for Raw. What else you want? Eggs in your beer? And now, Austin getting a close look at the Undertaker cycle.
Back in the ring, big man. Come
on. And Flair is trying to get
come on, Derek. You can't. Would you not criticize that? I mean, what referee is going to let something like that go on?
Oh, wait a minute. What the hell is this? We've already seen Scott Hall tonight. And thanks to X-Pac, Hall beat Bradshaw earlier tonight. The NWOs have big problems with Ric Flair. They've had big problems with Stone Cold. And I don't know that the NWOs is sending any How Are You Today cards to the Undertaker.
Oh, well, you're right. What are they doing out here?
I don't know.
Well, it's up to the referee to get rid of them.
Take around those steps. Austin's hurt, man. He's got a leg. In front of that, those steps got Austin right in that thigh.
Finally, Flair's showing some authority.
Back in the ring, man.
They're trying to get the Undertaker back. That's like changing the weather. You just can't do it. Need the face by the Undertaker, Austin. Getting hammered here. Flair is just, I'll tell you what,
Austin may have a broken nose.
Oh, hard right here. That was a knockdown by the Undertaker. And the NWO poison getting a little closer to the ring, and I don't understand even why they're here to get a look at this.
Well, they're here, all right. If you notice, they just keep creeping a little bit closer and closer. A couple of creeps. Look at this.
Scott Hall and X-Pac wearing the King's mask. Like
and they just keep getting a little bit closer.
Like a scalp. Checking on Austin. Austin holding that thigh. He really, the point of those steel steps drove into Austin's thigh. Now the Undertaker follows him back up with the elbow.
Yes.
And this match has been competed as much on the outside of the ring, quite frankly, as it has on the inside, it would seem to me.
Well, who do you blame for that? Ric Flair.
I'm not blaming Ric anybody.
Flair. You got to fault him for that.
Well, I don't know what your problem is with Ric Flair.
I mean, this was not signed. These guys didn't sign for a street fight or a hardcore match. You know that. But Flair's let it become that. Oh, look at that.
Oh, man.
That did it.
Undertaker dropping that huge leg right across Austin. And
NWO was impressed by that.
Again, I have no idea, no logical reason that the NWO is here.
Maybe the monitor is out back in there wrestling.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe not.
They have their own monitor back there.
Austin trying to fight his way back up. The Undertaker taking the legs of Austin from him again. Austin fighting up as quickly as he can. Now the Undertaker taking down the rattlesnake and dropping that 300 plus pounds right on that injured thigh of Stone Cold Steve Austin. Austin, the bionic redneck with those two knee braces supporting his legs. And that's now the focus of the Undertaker to punish Austin. Take his legs away.
Well, the Undertaker saw that injury to Austin's leg. He saw Austin favoring that leg after it was driven into those steel steps, and now he's zeroed in on it. Like a shark, smells blood.
Undertaker now looking for a submission move here in that must have hyperextended the leg there. Got the leg grapevine. You can see it's hard from that angle, but there you see it right there.
Get around there, Flair. Get in position. Austin may tap out.
Austin trying to fight to those ropes, and Flair got a good look at that. Austin reaching, and now he's in the ropes. And the referee called him to the break, and you gotta get the break. Undertaker continue to punish Stone Cold.
Undertaker just said no. He blatantly told him, wait a minute. Flair put his hands on the Undertaker.
I'm not sure. Austin just put his foot on the Undertaker. Right in his grin back. Austin now fighting back. The Texas Rattlesnake trying to fight back, but he's going on one leg here. And the Undertaker catches Austin. Got the lateral press there and got a near fall. Austin able to kick out. And now the Undertaker using that weight to press down on Austin's neck. Trying to make sure that he's not going to get a full breath of air there.
Everybody in here checking out the NWO. They're doing nothing. They're just standing there watching.
Now, you condone that? I got no business out here, King. You know that.
You and I are just sitting here watching.
We're paid to be out here to do this. They're wrestlers. They've already wrestled enough. Austin, that neck by Undertaker. Now you got leverage and strength advantage.
Not blocking anybody's view or anything. Go!
Oh, they're nice guys. You can trust them. They're good human beings. They love the business.
Look at it.
Shot by the Undertaker again. And boy, he is in the driver's seat is the Undertaker. Hey. Right hands. Austin is just he's like a sitting duck here. He just raked the Undertaker's eyes. And Undertaker comes back with a clubbing blow on the floor. Now pinning predicament here. And Austin able to kick out. This has been a mighty ground attack in the last several minutes by the Undertaker. Nothing fancy about this whatsoever.
Uh-oh,
and Austin the sleeper. Austin trying to slow the Undertaker down with a sleeper hold.
He didn't get behind the Undertaker. Oh!
The Undertaker counters in the suplex.
That sleeper, you got to get behind your opponent for it to be effective.
And Undertaker the cover. And Flair's got coming down for the three count.
What happened to Flair? Did arthritis strike him or something? My gosh.
Has he counted any differently anytime he's...
That may have been the slowest count in the history of the WWF right there.
A little slower than the others?
Much.
Up, Austin.
A little bit.
Again, back in the neck vice, the Undertaker punishing Austin. Austin, a big bruise there. You see on his thigh there. That's where he went to those steps earlier on his right thigh. And that's what the Undertaker was working that leg just a few minutes ago. And Austin hammering the Undertaker with right hands causes some separation. You just got to wonder how much P&V Austin's got in those right hands after being hammered. Getting ahead of steam here. Undertaker.
Hey!
Austin looking for the stunner. Oh, and Undertaker looked and found the clothesline. There's a lateral press. There's a cover. And oh, Austin kicked out and got to the stomach.
Oh, look at that look.
Not a real endearing look by the Undertaker, I'll tell you.
May have to give him a WrestleMania moment.
And Undertaker's a big forearm right across the face of Austin. Punishing. And the NWO looking on. That, I feel so repulsed to see X-Pac in that Kane mask.
Earlier you said he looked good in it.
Who did?
You said it was improvement.
Oh, improves his looks. Yeah, that don't take much. Kane convalescing. We don't know the details of Kane's recovery.
And if you think it's repulsive, you think it's repulsive to see what X-Pac looks wearing, you should see what Kane looks like without it.
Well, that's something he couldn't help being in a fire. Oh, as the Undertaker gets fired on here now by Austin, those right hands. And Stone Cold back to the right hands. And they're finding their mark. This is a clothesline. And the Undertaker goes airborne. Catches Austin the clothesline. Will that be enough there? The lateral press. And Austin kicking out with everything he's got that goes right to his stomach, which is a smart move. And you got to believe, King, at least I would suspect that the Undertaker is getting just a little bit frustrated right now.
I guess so with those slow counts from Ric Flair.
Wait a minute.
I get frustrated too. What's he doing?
Undertaker is getting either a close look at the turnbuckle or he's taking it off. I suspect the latter. And I suspect him right on that one. That turnbuckle exposed.
Now, let me ask you this. Would a good referee notice that the turnbuckle cover was gone?
Yes, he would, especially an experienced referee, which Flair is not.
Oh, look at Undertaker.
Ooh, Undertaker went right into that exposed turnbuckle. Spine first, ducks the clothesline, and both men colliding. Both men had the same idea.
Now what are you going to do, Flair?
These two men that are no doubt Hall of Fame bound in the World Wrestling Federation both had the same idea. And they both have another idea in common. That is to meet the winner of the Hollywood Hogan Triple H match at Judgment Day.
Flair's confused. He's like a statue standing there.
I don't think he wants to go to the countout.
Do something.
Maybe he's internalizing. Maybe he's counting internally. Maybe he's counting amongst himself.
Internally?
Well, maybe not.
He never counted.
Austin pulling himself back up. I said it earlier, he's an inexperienced referee. And Austin now fighting back. But at least he's on. What? He's teeing off in the Undertaker.
What?
I said it. Stop.
Oh, man, here we go.
Dumping that mud hole. Walking dry is Stone Cold Steve Austin. Austin now beating down the Undertaker.
I think Austin is about to get that proverbial second win here. Look out, Undertaker.
Austin's in the Undertaker for the ride. We got Pop coming in. Undertaker catching Austin coming in.
Oh, boy.
Now has him up. Well, look out here. Undertaker would love to deliver the tombstone. Or the last ride on Stone Cold. Austin threw the Undertaker. And Flair was in the wrong time. Flair in the wrong place at the wrong time.
He's stunned as well.
And Austin got the stunner on the Undertaker.
Not Flair.
The hook of the leg.
Not Flair.
Indeed, more than three.
Oh, he'd have been about to a three count by Flair by now. Get up, Flair.
Austin now going to Flair and trying to revive the Nature Boy. Austin scored with a stunner.
Look at Flair. Where am I? Who am I?
And, a low blow. Undertaker, the blatant low blow that went undetected by the referee, Ric Flair. And Undertaker now re-seizing the advantage.
Everything's going undetected by referee Ric Flair. You're gonna see this.
Undertaker, right on pull here.
Oh, man.
And there's a choke slam. The Undertaker with a choke slam. And that's got to be all. Flair is up. Another count. And a three. Oh, no. Austin kicked out.
I'm begging you, JR. What kind of count? Undertaker.
King, he's been the same count every time.
I know it.
I mean, what does Undertaker got to do here? What else can he do?
Get another referee?
He's chokeslammed Austin. He's hitting with a low blow.
And you'll get a steel
chair. And this is not real smart on the Undertaker's part because he loses this match with disqualification.
Well, he's had enough, JR. Look at Flair, look at Flair.
And Austin comes back with a low blow of his own.
Hey!
Flair unarmed the Undertaker. Austin came the low blow of his own. It's reversed right. Oh, the Undertaker caught Austin. That big foot right to the face. The big foot right to the face. And that's going to be it here. No, it's not. Austin again reaching down into his toes to kick out here.
Oh, boy.
And it was a two count. Flair reconfirms with the Undertaker. Fine muscle by Austin. The hook to the leg. Flair's got him in good position, but the Undertaker kicked out. Flair was in great position. Austin thought he had the Undertaker. Austin one and three, got two.
You're gonna have to really do something to get a three out of Ric Flair.
Austin wants that one more stunner. He hit the stunner earlier. Flair was out of position there. And there's another.
Oh,
Undertaker countered the stunner, and Austin went sailing right into Flair. And now the Undertaker's got that steel chair.
Yes, he does.
Flair is down. Austin is barely able to stop. Oh, my God. Undertaker using that steel chair as a weapon, cracking the cranium of the Texas Rattlesnake. Oh, come on, this can't happen this way. Come on, wait a minute. No, Austin kicked out and Flair did not see the chair shot.
Undertaker cannot believe this.
Both these men, Austin and the Undertaker, knew what they would be in for in this match.
Flair, please get in the corner and stay out of the way.
Uh-oh. Undertaker signifying that the end is near.
You know what that means? Could it be the last ride for the Rattlesnake?
That's exactly what you got to believe the Undertaker's thinking. Oh, wait a minute. Undertaker, look at that submission move. Austin countered the clothesline. Got a hook of the leg. One, two, and another near fall. Flair is.
Now, was that count the same speed, JR? Or did that just speed up just a little bit?
It might have been a little faster.
Oh, yeah, it might have been.
Austin now using the Undertaker's his finishing maneuvers with the Undertaker using his strength to power Austin back into the corner and catching Austin those elbows.
Not the chair again.
If Flair sees his chair being used, he's going to disqualify the Undertaker for damn sure. He makes contact with Austin. Firing back up. Austin further contact with the chair. Austin now stumbling away at the Undertaker. And Austin now with a chair, and he's got to be damn sure careful. They're trying to unarm Stone Cold Steve Austin. You don't want to get disqualified. Oh, my God. Austin just got the shot. The chair up back to his face. The cover. Hey, wait a minute. Hey. Wait a minute. Austin Fumbles on the run.
Well, there's your
here
referee.
Is your winner, the Undertaker.
How did he not see that, JR?
The Undertaker. His foot right in that steel chair that caught Austin in the face, but I guarantee Austin on his foot on the bottom rope.
I saw it, you saw it.
Flair obviously or apparently didn't see Stone Cold's foot on the bottom rope, but irregardless, the Undertaker is the number one contender for the undisputed title.